My heartiest welcome to all the participants. His Excellency Sanjay Kumar Verma, His Excellency Mr. Satoshi Suzuki, members, the Honorable Chief Minister from Government of Karnataka, my colleagues and companies who are participating in this session today. I would like to take this opportunity to present to you the opportunities available in the state of Tamil Nadu. The state of Tamil Nadu is a vibrant economic center in the country. Next slide, please. I will basically cover my presentation in five parts. We'll go with Tamil Nadu at a glance. We'll cover some focus sectors which the Tamil Nadu government is presenting to investors. We will showcase our infrastructure highlights, tell a little bit about the policy and regulatory support and infrastructure support to any investor here. Next slide, please. Next slide. So Tamil Nadu is one of the second largest economy in the states, contributing roughly to 8% of national GDP. Our growth rate, GDSP growth rate, in fact, this year was about 8% compared to the national growth rate, which is, it stands at about half. So Tamil Nadu has actually led the growth story from the front. Our GDP is roughly $250 billion, about equal to the size of 46th largest economy in the world. We have a very vibrant local population with highest urbanization in this in the country, which presents a large domestic market to any company which is aiming to use the domestic tariff area for production and sales. We have a good land area, which gives us the opportunity to expand industrial production across the state. We are the 10th largest state and a great long coastline with a lot of connectivity to the external world. Next slide, please. So let me start with the, what is it is there for investors in Tamil Nadu? We are the largest, concentration possibly of the global Fortune 500 companies. We have about 74 global Fortune 500 companies. The largest number of factories in the entire country are situated in Tamil Nadu. We have large number of industrial clusters, largest concentration of SEZs. We have ready-made availability of about 8 million square feet of plug-and-play facility, a ready-made move-in kind of industrial land of about 20,000 acres in developed by the state in various parts of the state. The R&D ecosystem in Tamil Nadu is one of the best. Recently, in one of the National Institute ranking framework, the out of the top 100 institutions ranked, 18 are in Tamil Nadu, which is the highest in anywhere across Tamil Nadu. It has a system of great R&D centers of multinational companies. We have a great ecosystem of universities here across the length and breadth. And that is giving fillip to a very great rising ecosystem for startups in the country, in the state. Another one of the great features of Tamil Nadu is that we have a power surplus here. We are expected to be power surplus for about next 10 years. Another really great thing about the power supply here, which many multinationals look forward, is the green power. We are one of the largest producers of renewable energy, and I'll talk a little bit about that later. In terms of connectivity, Tamil Nadu is really well connected to the rest of the world, which reduces your logistics cost for export and import both. We have five large seaports, four international and two domestic airports, and a large number of ICDs and CFS for logistics purposes. Tamil Nadu was in the news some time ago for a shortage of water. And what I would like to point out here is that the government has taken strong steps, as you can see from the left-hand side, the number of plants that have been put on either treating the sewage or from the reverse osmosis through the seawater. We will become weather independent of water for both industrial and domestic purposes. Another feature which companies look at is a robust and a well-skilled manpower. And Tamil Nadu again excels itself here. We produce roughly 1 million graduates per annum, which feed to not only our state, but to many neighboring states as well. The state government has a very strong policy support and incentive mechanism. We keep coming out with recent policies. So for example, one of our policies has been very well appreciated, the electric vehicle policy. It came out just recently. We are also revamping the industrial policy, and we'll be coming out very soon on that. The governance in Tamil Nadu is known for stability over decades, with companies finding promises kept and incentives given to them in time. Next slide, please. I would also like to mention that Chennai is emerging with a great amount of submarine connection capacity and a large bandwidth as the data center hub, and also it has been known as the SaaS, software as a service center, leader in the country. One of the sectors which Tamil Nadu is strong is the automobile and auto component sector. We are one of the 10 top automobile hubs in the world. We roughly sell about 2 million vehicles even domestically within the state. We account for roughly 35% of the India's auto production, roughly half India's motor vehicles, cars and export, and one third of motor vehicles, trailers and vehicles produced in India. Every second vehicle which is exported from the country is from Tamil Nadu. And if you see the installed capacity, we produce one car every 20 seconds and one commercial vehicle every 90 seconds. Tamil Nadu has the largest tire manufacturing capacity here. We have multiple R&D centers supporting fundamental research and in terms of global capability centers. A strong system of backward and forward linkages with metal industries, capital equipment, trucking, warehousing, logistics, you name it. And all of these and the partners who are here at the bottom of the slide go on to show that Tamil Nadu is numero uno in the auto sector. Next slide, please. Electronics and hardware sector is something which I would again like to highlight as the strength of Tamil Nadu. We rank second in computer electronics and optical manufacturing. We have a 16% of national production is produced here. 62% of share comes from Tamil Nadu on computer and peripherals in the domestic production in the state. And we are third in electronic exports. There is a great synergy between the electronics as a OEM, you know, the OEM and the producers who are there in automotive, mobile phones and components, telecom, consumer durables, medical electronics, semiconductor fabrication. And you can see that Tamil Nadu has a great place in the mobile production, and our partners below are standing evidence of that. Thank you. Next. If we look at the general manufacturing sector, which we are, you know, Tamil Nadu again has a great potential here. We are the first in the number of factories in India with about 37,000 factories across the state. We are second in heavy engineering exports, third in general purpose and special purpose machinery production, which supports roughly 2.5 lakh people for employment. We have all the big players in the state, especially from Japan, and who are critical to this ecosystem of general manufacturing, which is again a strength, and due to its both forward and backward linkages, again is a great place to invest. Next. The next strength of Tamil Nadu, which the state government really wants, especially in the post-COVID times, is investments to support chemicals and petrochemicals. We already rank third in the total chemicals output. We contribute 6% of the nation's total chemicals output. We have been very healthily growing at about 15% between 12-13 and 15-16. we are contributing to about 13% of CAGR on chemical products in exports itself. And with 20,000 acres of land and Thoothukudi, the southern district, which poises itself as a chemical and petrochemical hub with logistics efficiencies, is and a lot of investments coming around there in petrochemicals, is poised to give a robust ecosystem for any future investments. Our partners, who are listed here, are an evidence to the robust ecosystem in chemicals and petrochemicals and the growth opportunities. Next slide, please. The next strength of Tamil Nadu really lies in textiles and garmenting. We are looking at technical textiles and in various categories, industrial textiles as well, as the growing opportunity in across the world that can be met from Tamil Nadu. We have an export of about $6 to $7 billion from Tamil Nadu per annum. We contribute about 40% of the yarn in India, and that's why we call the yarn bowl. 59% of the textile mills are in Tamil Nadu. Half the garmenting units are in Tamil Nadu. Being a leading producer and in terms of inputs and also in terms of final goods, we are now really seeking investments in advanced textiles, technical textiles, various kinds of technical textiles to our state. We would welcome this, especially because this provides a large amount of employment to a large populace, and therefore it is a focus sector for the state. Next slide, please. Medical devices and pharmaceutical sector, as I said, again, it is critical to the state and to the country, especially with Atmanirbhar program. We are the fifth largest pharmaceutical manufacturing state with about 400 plus companies specializing in bulk drugs, formulations and medical devices. Our output was about 1.1 billion and our share in exports was basically have the largest share through surgicals and medical devices. The state really is giving heavy emphasis to promote this sector in the state, and we wish to become numero uno again in this pharma and medical devices sector. The state is actually setting up a 300 acre Medi Park in Chengalpet, which is near Chennai, and also a bulk drug park with the state of art shared and common facilities for R&D. We already have our partners listed below, and we wish to see you join this story, which is really a boon and an opportunity for all investors in this sector. Next slide. Tamil Nadu again prides itself on a large and a vibrant agriculture and food processing sector. We contribute roughly 8% of the food processing output, and we have second highest number of food processing units in the country. Our food processing exports and agriculture exports was about $2 billion last year, and we aim to continue the rapid growth in this sector by inviting investments in food processing, cold chains, and various other allied value-added industries. As you can see, we have a very robust presence of players from the sector. All well-known players are present in Tamil Nadu. Next slide, please. Aerospace and defense is another area where the state is really very keen to seek investment, and we are one of the two corridors announced by Government of India. We have an exclusive park which has been set up near Chennai, which is shortly coming up with both ready facilities for R&D and high speed advanced computing, along with a dedicated place for companies to set up their operations. We already have about 120 aerospace manufacturing companies with more than 700 suppliers to various defense companies. And as you can see in the map, we have a very wide range, geographically spread defense and aerospace companies already in the state. We will be giving a good amount of incentives, and we seek investments in MRO, in precision manufacturing, small manufacturing, missile fabrications. These are all opportunities for investment because already capacities exist here. Next slide, please. So this just shows, the importance of, renewable energy. We are the ninth destination in terms of capacity ranking across the world, in terms of producing renewable energy. And that mix actually is very attractive for most companies who are looking for green production. Next slide. Next slide, please. Next slide. Yeah. So Tamil Nadu has a very good incentive system in place, where we provide capital subsidies, stamp duties exemptions, electricity tax exemption. We also provide land allotment concession for industries who come to our industrial parks. There is a robust training subsidy for people who are brought into the industrial ecosystem. We also have, on a case-to-case basis, for large investments, payroll subsidy and special capital subsidy as well. Next slide, please. So, to our relationship with Japan and is very, very special. We have the second largest number of Japanese companies operating in India, 620 companies, largest number of Japanese expat community. Since 2011, we have attracted 54 new Japanese companies who have invested roughly $5.4 billion. We have bilateral arrangements with several prefectures, and we use this opportunity to urge the new Japanese investors to come into Tamil Nadu. As you can see, that they have a very robust presence all across the periphery and around Chennai. Lot of companies are there, Toshiba, Yamaha, Panasonic, Mitsubishi, and they are all our partners in progress, and their experience has been great, wonderful. Let's go to the next slide, please. So this is just showcasing opportunities for basic requirement, that is a land across the state of Tamil Nadu. We have lands available everywhere. Next, please. Tamil Nadu, of course, ranks very high in National Good Governance Index. We are number one. We are the second best metro in the Ease of Living Index by Government of India. We have a great educational system for expats and their children. Great recreational facilities, which are very well valued by Japanese investors. Next slide, please. I only like to showcase one success story. Yamaha Music Manufacturing Plant, they signed the MOU in January 2019. And they inaugurated their plant by May 2019. So they proceeded very fast, and that just shows the support of the state government to make sure that investors get to doing their business. Next slide, please. So I represent Guidance and the MD CEO. We are the nodal agency for investment. We are the first point of contact for investors. We have a single window portal, as most states have. We have something special where the state has launched something called BizBuddy for any industry in the state who's operating and has a help request to make to the state government. We take that electronically on board and ensure that any support is given within 30 working days. We have a lot of sector specific desks, country desks, and we continuously work towards improving ease of doing business. And therefore, what I want to promise to you is that we will give you a pleasant experience for your investments. Our motto is open 24, which means we are open 24 hours a day. We work 24/7, and we aim to respond to any of your query within 24 hours. So with these words, I thank you again, and welcome to all Japanese investors to Tamil Nadu.